Yep. Rip. Look at True Boogie and Dante fucking just becoming good buddies. Karen sitting on Dante's lap. It's just a big happy family when Patrice goes away. You traitor motherfuckers. Kiss her neck. Telling her it's all radio. It's
fucking bastards.
You really are a good fucking cop, bad cop. Dante really does. This fucker really. After I take a swing at him, Dante goes, "Hey, man, you know, it is terrible you did take a swing at me, baby. Come here. Did he hit you? Come here." As he's a worse motherfucker than me. People don't even know it. I want everybody to know Dante ain't shit. Fucking guy ain't shit. I know this.
He pat his love. He goes, "Come here, Karen."
Yeah, okay. It's all right. You're doing great, kissing her on her cheek. Well, I'm taking a shit. I love that commercial. That's the best commercial. I'm a man. A manly, manly man. You know, it's like, I want to just go take a dump, and they're in here going, "No, no, no, Pudding Pop, come here. That fur coat you got, that's beautiful. Why did Patrice say it ain't shit?" He's so mean. And Dante likes wearing shit that girls... "Oh my God, is that a rattlesnake? Is that a rattlesnake tail?"
I didn't know that to say that.
Really? See, this nigga here, he wears bones in his ears. You know, the nigga took his own eyeballs out and put in, like, dolphin eyes or something.
It's his hook.
And then, "Oh my God, is that an actual cup of scorpion poison?"
"Yeah, baby, but you're drinking and shitting right there. It'll, what it does is clean out your,
that's what I call,
ooglioglia system." Fuck up, you.
That's what I call a peacock.
This fucker's wearing, this nigga has on a rattlesnake tail.
He does. It's hot.
Fuck are you, Chief Little Hawk nigga? Fuck is wrong with you?
This is my grandfather's.
That's the bullshit, nigga. I swear to God. That's what a nigga do. He go, "Why you got a bald head?" "I got cancer." And then fuck up everything.
Well, nah, my mom gave me this. It was my grandma. My mother is Sioux Indian, half Sioux Indian. Swear to God.
You have to turn it into actual.
Now, I want to, but I want to say this.
That's fascinating.
Exactly. And nigga's
that
like,
is the point,
nigga.
Because I only bought this from a novelty store. Stupid.
Aha, goofy. And I knew that. Ain't no real rabbit. That's why the niggas used to wear African pendants walking around. I was so happy when that shit was a style, African pendants, and I could just walk around and look good. Like, I'm from the Ogunga tribe, and this nigga here with a rattlesnake tail.
Let me tell you something. You always talk about the animal kingdom, the peacock. How does a peacock get the female peacock?
He shows them extra bullshit.
He makes pretty. Exactly. He makes pretty.
With all the colors, the feathers.
And she was all into it. Look at you. Dante got so many. You know what? He's smart. He got so many unorthodox horseshit charms on his neck. Like, what is this? Oh, my God. It's a rattlesnake. It's the rattlesnake that killed my great-great uncle Jim. And I choked it with my bare hands. You choked a rattlesnake? Then you gotta Google. Bitches are too dumb to Google. Length of time rattlesnake lives.
Rattlesnakes live
for a week and a half. How'd you kill the rattlesnake that killed your great-great-grandfather? Killed him yesterday.
I'm usually fucking by then.
And fucking, and after you come in the face, you go, "I stung you, bitch." Bitches are so goofy. And this nigga just told, "You want this?" Nigga got six. Nigga got six rattlesnakes. And he wears a shark tooth on Thursday. Niggas are awful, man. All right, man. We're going to come back to call. Hey, Bob from Pittsburgh, man.
Oh, my goodness.
Bob.
What's up?
How are you, sir?
Good, good.
How's the family? What, nigga? Come on, Bob.
Tell your story.
What's up, man?
What's up? Not much.
Okay.
All right.
Come on, awkward.
Come on,
talk to me.
We got like 15 minutes.
Yeah, man. Go ahead, man.
My bad, man. I'm just a little high. I'm calling because I was dating this girl for 2.5 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, she just fucking up and left me for another guy. And now she's still, like, talking to me and stuff,
mm-hmm.
and telling me, like, "I kind of want you back, but I have feelings for him." And then the other day she told me how much she misses me, but She's starting to love him now.
Well, there's a name. There's a name for you. It's called Plan B, and it's a good name. Yep. Your name is Bob. You are Plan B for Bob. All right. She's keeping you as a comfort zone.
Break glass.
In case. Let me tell you something, Bob. And I have to move along. But and I apologize. I want to give everybody time. But what she's doing is she's making sure that this guy that taps into her animalism more than you. She's just making sure he's a safe, like, haven to leave you for. Meaning, she knows you're always going to be her little good thing when it comes to, like, it's okay. So as soon as she feels comfortable that this fucking guy is okay and not a piece of shit, because he is a piece of shit, you know why, Bob? Because she likes him. She likes the guy and loves the guy. He's a dick. That's why you got to start learning how to be a dick, Bob. Just learn it. If you can't just start going, fuck you. It's technique. I'm going to tell you what my girl did, and it's very hard. I'm diabetic. People know that shit. Got to take pills. My girl uses my sickness as a way to check on me, as a way to be in my face and a way to be concerned. And it's very difficult for me to say to her, bitch, stop worrying about my health. I can't say that.
Yeah.
So I have to figure out a way to come back, because she thinks she found a way to just wiggle into my fucking system, where she'll call me if I don't answer, then she'll call me again, then she'll call my house, then she'll call my car, right? Okay, I was worried.
Why can't I just be being concerned? Because we naturally are.
One more thing about her. She was nuts. She's still nuts, because if she hears I'm out with, like, other chicks and shit, she'll get all jealous and be like, I thought you loved me and shit like that.
That's
wrong.
She's pimping you.
Dude, that's pimp move number three in the handbook. And she learned it. And the only way she can play that game is because you're her good little thing. You got to take that strap-on dildo out of your booty, and I'm not being mean to you, Bob. It's she's ramming you, and she's fucking you and kissing him. You understand?
Yeah, I know.
She's using you to keep confidence over him, because she feels fucked up. You know what she's doing, Bob? If you heard the show, she's dating up. You're her penguin. You're the guy that gives her confidence, so she goes back to the male shark, and he goes, "Where you went? Where you been, bitch?" That's what you are. You're a little bitch, and I don't, you know, that's it. Hey, Bob, it is what it is. See you later, buddy. Let me go to Josh in Ohio. Josh. Josh?
Yo.
What up, Josh?
What's up, Tree?
Nothing much.
Hey, man. I gotta just tell you, man, everybody out there, that everything you're saying, man, all the points you're making is fucking true. That's for real. I've been with my girl for 8 years,
Josh, are you high?
Leave him alone. Let him fucking, I don't give a fuck if he's retarded. You let him get his praise out. Go ahead, Josh. Finish praising me.
Come on.
Thank you. Charlie from Tennessee, man. Oh, jeez, this one's going to be, this is not going to be good. Charlie?
Yeah, go ahead.
You there, Charlie?
This is Charlie.
All right, this is Patrice O'Neill. Ooh, Charlie, you're on the show.
Shit.
What's up, Mr. P?
Hey, man.
I want to know what's up with all these women cheating on all their husbands, getting shot up in Iraq. Because that happened to me.
Oh,
holy
no.
Shit, your what? Wait, oh, your girl is fucking... Well, now, let's be honest here, Charlie. Let's just ask you a question. We have to be fair. Was you getting some of that third world hooker pussy out there? Be honest.
Negative.
No, you was being right to her. That's fucked up, dude. So how'd you find out? She left you for the dude?
No, when I come back, which was earlier than expected, I found a guy in the bed.
Wait a minute, you came from fucking dealing with these filthy Arabs, came home and found a motherfucker. So you came on some old surprise visit shit?
I had an eviction notice on the door, an empty bank account, and everything of mine gone, and cocaine on the table. She was spending all of my combat money on drugs and her boyfriend. I was gone.
Now let me ask you, you're not calling, first thing, you're not calling from jail and no shit like that, right?
I've never been in jail in my life.
But no, I'm saying, you didn't, you, I mean, here's what I'm saying. I'm giving you complete credit for not putting a fucking
two hot ones in the cabbage.
Right?
What's that prison?
Two beans in the cabbage.
For putting an Abu Ghraib on these motherfuckers. So you kept your composure and you didn't do nothing harmful to them.
No, thank God I don't have a couple bullets lined up, but...
Fuck me.
Do
How
that.
Long ago was this, man?
Don't do that.
Yeah, I got
Charlie, how long ago did this happen?
This happened 4 years ago.
How long were you in Iraq at the time?
I was in Iraq for 3 years. I was over there from the beginning.
You still hurt 4 years ago and shit. So, I mean, have you seen her? Have you heard from her? Nothing.
She won't let me see my kid or anything, no.
Oh, you got a kid with this bitch. This is hard. This is a tough one. I don't know what to do.
Can you talk to her in-laws, to your in-laws, to her parents?
No.
Did you file for custody with the kids?
They had my rights taken away in absentia by the judge.
Oh, because you weren't there.
I wasn't there yet.
That's
holy
insane.
Shit. Wait a minute. Why is she saying she fucking did this shit?
I think he can refile.
He can refile
because
he's back?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
You know, Dante knows about some shit because he knows some. Because Dante's like a. He's a dad, but it's not his kid, right?
Yeah.
So, but he raised him, so he knows a lot of this shit. You can refile again.
I think
again.
You can file now that you're back.
Now, why is she saying that she did this shit to you?
She's a piece of shit.
She had no reason.
She's just a fucking bitch.
And if she's coked out.
Yeah.
I don't know what to do about the kids.
I think you can, I think, Charlie, you can refile now that you're back. Are you working now?
No, I'm a disabled veteran.
Do you have a place that you're staying or no?
Yeah, I have a place I'm staying.
Is it how many kids you got?
That one. That's it.
Just one. Do you have a place that you can accommodate this kid?
Oh yeah, I have a 180-acre farm.
Okay, well then you.
Wait a minute. Does he want the kid though?
Yeah, like he's saying he wants
to. So
see
you
the kid.
You want your kid?
I definitely do not want my little girl around a crack.
Around that shit.
Not.
Okay, you can
not.
Then you can file you if you're back and you have a stable place, you can refile now that you're back. Did you try to do that?
I didn't know I could.
Yeah, you can after the absentia, you can refile now that
even
you.
If gotten the custody and the name changed and everything?
You can still file. You can
you're still legal.
No court is gonna not allow you to see your kids if you're what's your name? How long have you been back since you've been back?
I've been back about a year.
So last year you found this bitch in the bed with the dude and the coke.
Yep.
Okay, you can refile. You can definitely refile because no court is gonna not allow you to see your kids.
Does
a
nigga have proof?
He's a veteran.
Yeah, that's what I was going
to
ask.
Do you got proof she's a junkie and all that shit?
I want to know how I'm going to get all my money back. She spent all $80,000 on
you ain't getting that back, man.
That's gone.
You might as well drop that. But what, do you have proof that she's on coke and all that shit?
Oh, hell yeah.
You get your kids if you really want your kids. But here's the thing I would say, dude. I'm going to tell you. Here's how you cannot operate, and this is some of your fucking army training shit. You cannot operate on an emotional level with this, man,
because
you will kill yourself.
Right.
It's just like
or
in,
somebody else.
It's just right. It's just like in
or
the
both.
Army where you know you over there in Iraq, and I know that some people take it personal.
Yeah.
Like when you're shooting at people, motherfuckers shooting at you, and you can't. Sometimes you want to go be fucking raghead and kill them, but you just can't do that.
Yeah.
You got to go into whatever operation. Fuck this hoe.
Right.
And take a deep breath, and you take because you got time. You don't work. You're disabled.
Yep.
You got time to get this shit right. You do it right. Don't do it like a vengeance move, dude.
Right.
You do it with righteousness. You understand what I'm saying?
One step at a time.
You understand?
I'll be in the mode of it's business.
And thank you. Mm-hmm. Operation, you're a soldier. Operation, repeat after me.
Operation
fuck this hoe.
Operation.
Hey man, good luck, dude. Good luck, man.
Seriously.
I feel for you, man. I really do.
Seriously.
How much time we got left, Danny?
We got about 3 minutes.
3 minutes?
Yeah.
Hey, listen, man. Tell motherfuckers I can't take the call, dude. No more calls today. I'm sorry.
Aww.
I'm sorry, Tim, Christian, fucking Matt. Michelle, Michelle, question about shaving pussy. Oh,
and I would have totally
John,
answered that.
John, Jim, yeah. Kyle, because we could get in that forever. You know what? Call next time, man. I'm going to try. You know what, Danny, ain't we trying to put this on more often?
Yeah, I'm trying to do that.
It's like a bi-weekly thing or something like that.
Yeah, you know, everybody.
Because Billy got something coming on next week, right?
Yeah, Bill next Bird, week will be Bobby Bill Burr. Yep.
They're trying to move us in there, but I mean, everybody who's been listening to the Black Phillip Show,
right.
and if we do it again, of course everybody's gonna listen. I thank you for calling, dude.
Yeah.
We're trying to work out the fact that I like to talk, and you can't help the fact that. That was actually a fucking call that's more important than whether you shave your pussy or not, you selfish bastards. But listen, wait, we gotta do the little couple of plugs. Let me do my plug first. Where's my theme music, motherfucker? I want theme music. Come on,
all right,
Danny.
Hang on.
You bastard. No theme music.
That's the 2 minute warning. That's the warning.
All right, listen.
I got it for you.
Next week I'm gonna be what's the date on that? Oh, okay. February 9th and 10th, Patrice O'Neill, which is me, is going to be a stand-up New York on 78th and Broadway in Manhattan. That's stand-up New York. The number is 212. 212-